doubting whether one's ablution has been invalidated. This happens a lot. I leave home, I go to work, it's time for Dhuhr prayer, and I think to myself, is my wudu valid or not? This is scenario one. Scenario two, I think, am I in the state of wudu or not? Have I performed wudu or not? These are two different issues. If I am certain that I left home in the state of wudu, for example, I prayed Fajr, I went home, had breakfast, left to work at 7 o'clock, and now it's Dhuhr time. I know that I left in the state of wudu. Now I'm doubting, did I answer the call of nature? Did I pass wind? Did I do anything to invalidate my wudu? These are doubts. With the certainty that I have left home in the state of wudu, the doubts evaporate and disappear. So I am in wudu, I can pray. I have no problem in that. The second scenario is different. I prayed Fajr, went to sleep. Then after an hour, woke up, had breakfast, went to work. Dhuhr time is due. Now I'm in doubt. Did I perform wudu or not? Not the other way around. Did I nullify my wudu? My wudu was certain in the first incident. Here, I'm not sure whether I performed wudu or not, which means that the default is that I'm not in the state of wudu. And I'm doubting whether I performed wudu or not. In this case, definitely I'm not in the state of wudu and I have to perform wudu. This is a usuli rule. And they call it al-yaqinu la yazulu bil-shak. Certainty is not removed by doubts. I am married and I keep getting these whispers. Did I divorce my wife? Was I intending to divorce her when I said I've had enough? These are doubts. What is certain? That I'm married. I have a paper proving it. I have kids proving it. The doubts is something that is not of a reality, that has no impact on what is default. Cast it away and throw it in the dustbin.